Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. Today we are diving deep into a powerful and versatile function, the sum product formula in Excel. Whether you are a beginner or an advanced user, this function can be a game changer for your data analysis. Stick around as we explore how to use the sum product formula, its syntax, and practical examples. Let's get started. Before we jump into practical examples, let's understand what the sum product formula is and why it's a must-know for Excel users. The sum product formula in Excel is a versatile function that allows you to multiply corresponding elements in multiple arrays or ranges and then sum the results. It's like having the power to perform complex calculations with ease. To use the sum product formula effectively, it's crucial to grasp its syntax. The syntax of the sum product formula is simple. Sum product, array 1, array 2, array 3. Array 1 represents the first array or range you want to multiply and sum. You can include more arrays if needed. They should all have the same dimensions. That's the only prerequisite. Now, let's see how the sum product formula works in real-world scenarios. We can use the sum product formula to perform simple tasks like calculating the total cost by multiplying quantities and prices, and then summing the results. Let's start with a simple example. Here we have our office products that we sell, and it looks like it's taken from an invoice. We have product names, quantities, and their respective price. To know the total amount, most of us would go for multiplying each item quantity with price in this column here, and then totaling them all at the bottom. You know what? Just to compare our results with this method and that of sum product, let's do that. Let's multiply our first quantity with the price here. And here we have the total for our pencils. Now let's copy this formula and paste it to the end. And now that we have the individual totals, all we have to do is use the sum formula to add all of them together. So let's do that now. So here we have our total 316,522. Now let's try this with the sum product formula. Let's write our formula right here. Sum product, let's choose this as array 1 and this one as array 2 and enter. And we have the same result. So in effect, we really didn't have to do all this individual multiplication and then adding them all up. Well, it appears that way. A single sum product formula has replaced all that. These are just 20 products. Imagine hundreds of such items, and using a single formula can save you so much hassle. Now let's move on to some interesting examples. Sum product can't be not simply just to multiply one array with another, right? This time, we have a list of the same products but with different prices, sold over a period of just 3 days. October 1 to October 3, 2023. Just as I said in our previous example, multiplying each quantity with price may not be a suitable solution in all situations. This is one of those situations. So, if we just have to find our total, like the last time, it's easy. You have already learned how to do that. We are going to do something different here. In this example, we are going to use some conditions instead. Let's say we need to find out how much revenue did we generate by selling pencils. That's pretty easy with our sum product formula, but we have to add something to our formula that most of you might not know about. It's called a double unary. In simplest terms, a double unary, which is denoted by two minus signs, is often used as a technique to convert a value into a numeric format. The longer definition is that it's an operation used to coerce true and false values to ones and zeros in advanced formulas such as sum product. But for the sake of this example, let's go with the simple explanation. I'll make a separate video about double unary to explain its usage. So, in effect, we have to make a formula in such a way that it only multiplies values for items as mentioned in our list here. So we write a formula as sum product, then use our double unary by placing two minus signs, and then open brackets and select a product column is equal to our value in our drop-down cell here. This will ensure that we only use our value in here and ignore everything else. Rest is simple. Now we need to select the columns to quantity and price to multiply. So select quantity for array 2 and price for array 3. Close brackets. And here we have our value. Now let me show you how the double unary works. If we select a logical argument, which is where we want to check our item names against our value in a dropdown, this part here, you will see how the double unary works in the background. You see these true false values, that's a formula checking each value against our value in the dropdown. Let me select, let's say, USB flash drives, which is third in our list here. And now let's go back again to check our formula. And you see at the third position, we have our value as true. So wherever USB flash drive is present, it will be true and the rest will be false. And following our remaining arrays of quantity and price, it will only multiply those with true values, and therefore we get to this value here. We can also use this formula to see what our revenue is after a certain date. Let's say we want to check our total revenue after a certain date. Let's quickly write that formula here. Sum product, double unary, open bracket, and choose our date column. And say we want to check all revenue after October 1. So we use the greater than symbol, and to mention our date, we use the date function. Year is 2023, month is October, that's 10, and day is 01. Double closing brackets, choose quantity as array 1 and price as array 3. Close brackets and press enter. Done. We have our total revenue for all the products sold after October 1, 2023. Now that we've done it with single condition, let's take it up a notch and try it with two conditions. Same data set as before, but this time we have added date to the mix as well. We know our data is for 3 days, October 1, October 2 and October 3. Say we need to find the total revenue for any item from any of these dates. We already have our columns for item and date here. Let's write our sum product formula here. We start by sum product, open bracket for our logical argument and select product column. And we want it to match this value in here. So we put equal to this column here, close brackets, and since we want to also check against the date, which means we need an AND argument, which is denoted by a multiplication symbol. So we put one here, open brackets again for a second logical argument, and this time select date column and equal to this one here, close brackets. This completes our logical argument. Now again, we simply choose quantity as our array 2 and price as our array 3, close brackets and done. You know what? Let's verify our results. It doesn't hurt to check our results once a while. So let's find our item which is repeated on a date. Let's filter date as October 1 from our filters. And by the looks of it, notebook appears thrice on this date. Let's choose this as our item in our dropdown and the date as October 01. And we get 19,591 as our result. Let's check that. Let's multiply the first instance here. Now the second, and finally the last one, and finally use our old plus shortcut to sum these, and we have the same result. So our formula works fine. Let's check it with another item, pens, which appear twice in the same date. So let's change our item name to pens, and now let's multiply quantity with price in our first occurrence. Now the second one. And finally, let's sum it up and it matches perfectly. So job done. You now know how to use sum product formula with two conditions using the AND operator. Let's move to see how to do it with more than two conditions. We already have item name and date as our conditions. Let's add quantity as well, so we have altogether three conditions to create a formula for. By now, you must be comfortable enough to guess how we add the third condition. It's simply using the AND operator, the multiplication symbol with the quantity. We'll choose notebooks in our item name, date as October 01 and quantity as 500. Now let's write our formula to find the revenue of the product in a dropdown which have quantity more than 500. Let's start with SUMPRODUCT. For our logical argument, let's start with opening brackets and selecting product column equal to our product name in a dropdown here, close brackets, multiplication symbol for our AND argument, open brackets, and now select the date column, close brackets, multiplication symbol again, open brackets again, select our quantity column and use a greater than symbol and choose the quantity cell here. Close brackets, and that completes a logical argument. Now simply select the quantity column as array 2 and price column as array 3, close brackets, and done. Here we have our value as 16,401. Let's see if our formula works. Let's find an item from October 1 which has less than 500 items. Here, folders. Let's choose folders here in our dropdown, and we have 0 as our result, which is perfect. With this, we come to the end of our video. Now you know what is the SUMPRODUCT formula and how to use it with multiple conditions. I have shown you how to use it with AND operator. You can try it yourself with the OR operator, which is mentioned as a plus sign as opposed to the multiplication sign for the AND operator. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more Excel tutorials, tips and tricks. Give us a thumbs up if you're ready to supercharge your data analysis. Thank you for joining us today. Keep practicing, keep exploring, and remember, with the SUMPRODUCT formula in your Excel arsenal, you can tackle even the most complex data analysis tasks. Until next time, happy spreadsheeting.